We're all familiar with the base 10 number system, or often called the decimal number system, where we have 10 digits, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And now we've started to see that we can have alternate number systems. We can have a base 2 number system, known as the binary number system, where instead of 10 digits, you only have 2 digits. And each place, instead of being a power of 10, is going to be a power of 2. Now you can imagine that we can keep extending this. We can extend to base 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or we could even go above 10. And what I want to expose you, what I want to show you in this video is a fairly heavily used number system that is larger than, or that has more digits than base 10, and that is base 16. Base 16, often called the hexadecimal. Hexadecimal number system. And as you can imagine, instead of only having 10 digits, it is going to have 16. So what are those digits going to be? And as we'll see, instead of the places being powers of 2 or powers of 10, they're going to be powers of 16. So let's see, we could reuse the existing 10 digits from the decimal number system. So we can reuse 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But then we're going to need to have 6 more digits. And so the convention is to use the first 6 letters. A, B, C, D, E, and F. And you might say, hey, this is crazy. These are letters, not numbers. But remember, these are just arbitrary squiggles of ink on a piece of paper. These are just arbitrary symbols that we've grown to associate with things. So you've grown to associate this symbol right over here with 8 things, with the word 8, which you associate with when you see that many objects. And so if you're thinking in hexadecimal, this isn't the letter A that makes you want to say ah, or the letter B that makes you want to say ba 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 ba. This is literally, this represents if you had 10 things laying around, you would say, I have A things over there. If you had 11, you'd say, I have B things over there. 12, C things. 13, instead of saying I have 13, you could say, I have D things there. And instead of saying I have 14, you could say, I have E things there. And instead of saying I have 15, you could say, I have F things there. Now, how does that help? Well, let's see if we can represent the same number, 231, or 231 in decimal, if we can represent that same number in hexadecimal. And what I'll do is I'll give you what the number is, and then I'll show you how we convert it. I'll show you the place value, and I'll show you how we convert it. So 231 in hexadecimal, 231 in hexadecimal is the number E7. And once again, you're like, this looks crazy. This looks like I'm playing like Battleship or something. What's E7? This is a number, and I would say, yes, this is a number. Now you remember, base 16, what do these place values represent? This first place represents 16 to the 0 power, or it still represents the ones place. This is the ones place. So this is 7 ones. Now what does this place here represent? Well, in base 10, that was 10 to the first power. In base 2, that was 2 to the first power. So in base 16, this is going to be, I'll leave those there. In base 16, this is going to be 16 to the first power. So this is literally, let me write out the word. This is literally 16s. So this is E16s plus 7 ones. And so let me write that down. This is E16s plus 7 ones. That's what this number represents. Now, if we want to start rewriting this or reconceptualizing it in our decimal number system, what is E16s? Well, the E, if we think in decimal, E is 14. E is 14. And so this is really, you could really think of this if you wanted to think in decimals. This is 14 sixteens. So what's 14 sixteens? Well, that's just the same thing as 14 times 16. 14 times 16 is equal to 224. Let me actually do that same color. So this thing is going to be this right over here is going to be 224. 14 16s. 14 times 16 is 224, plus 7 ones, plus 7 ones. Well, 224 plus 7 is going to give you 231. So hopefully you can appreciate, you can represent the same quantity in any different in any of these different number systems. And any number that you can represent in decimal, you can also represent that number in binary, or in hexadecimal, or in base 3, or in base 60, or in base 31, whatever you want to do. And you might have noticed a pattern. The more symbols that we have, so in base 16, you have 16 symbols, the less place values we need to represent the same quantity. And one way to think about it is each of the places are containing more information. This is one of 16 characters, while this over here is only one of 2 characters. This is one of 10 characters. So the more symbols that you have, the more digits that you could put in each place, the less places that you need to represent a given quantity. Another way to think about it is when you have a high base, like base 16, as you take powers of 16, what's the, you know, the next place right over here would be 16 squared, which of course is 256. You're clearly going to be able to represent bigger numbers faster, I guess you could say, or with less digits. So it's just an interesting thing to observe. But hopefully you get a kick out of, as much of a kick out of base 16 as I do. And it's actually useful. This actually is used if you look at most web pages. And if you look at the actual code for the, or I guess you could say the format, or the formatting, like the HTML for the web page, when they specify colors, they tend to specify it in hexadecimal. And that's because you're specifying the colors, the intensity of the red, the green, or the blue between 0 and 255. And so 2 digits of hexadecimal are perfect for that. Because if you think about it, what is FF? What would this be if you were to rewrite it in the decimal number system? And I encourage you after this video is done, I encourage you to do that, to figure that out on your own. And if you really want to do something fun, let me give you another one. Try to figure out what AF3 is. And this isn't anything special. I just wanted to give you another interesting thing to work on.